years, even though at times perhaps I did not live in New York, but we did together many, many great things for many years. When he passed on, I decided that it was time to do something perhaps a little bit more focused on him directly, because he was such a quiet person in his own way, and he never did things publicly, even though the end result is everybody knew what he was doing, but he didn't like it. I decided that I would do something a little more. I decided to open a synagogue in his name. The opening of the synagogue in his name, but whilst at it, it's not just, you can't just open a synagogue because there's many things that are related to it, and we decided to do the writing of a new Torah at that time, mm-hmm. and we wrote a new Torah, which is a new scroll, which is the parchment and the writing of the five books of Moses, and to place it inside the ark, inside the synagogue, so we have our own Torah to read from. The next step we decided is that in the morning when people come, so there are many, many children who are misfortunate, who are unfortunate, and they don't have to suffer, and that we would start a program of doing sandwiches for children. And it wasn't only just sandwiches, it finished off that there are many, many, there are tens of companies that help us weekly so that we can actually deliver food to people's homes. When you talk about a soup kitchen, for almost the first 9 months, we actually did have people that would come and eat a warm bowl of chicken with a warm bowl of soup with chicken in it, and so on and so forth. We did have that. We just now, over the holiday month, the last holiday month, we decided that we would bring it to their homes as opposed to having it out of the synagogue. And we are in the process right now of opening a full freestanding restaurant, which should be opened shortly, and we will be, and our focus is to help those that need to be helped so that they can actually sit in a gracious environment and eat a wonderful meal, and they feel nurtured, and they feel the nourishment, and so on and so forth. And to that, I'd like to relate a story why I decided to do that. And this is going back in 1992. In 1992, I was walking in one of the cities in New York with my dad, and I'd prefer not to mention the name of the city because of the area. And I was walking with my dad, and we were just talking. There was an older gentleman who was an art dealer at that time, and also he was a Judaica collector. Mm-hmm. And we were standing and talking to him in the street, and one of the creditors who he owes money to actually walked out of his car and walked up to him and said to him like this, and said to him, "You should know, you should be ashamed of yourself, and you should know that I'm going to publicize this, that you owe so much and so much money, and last night we happened to see you sitting in the restaurant and eating. Do you understand that you were sitting in the restaurant eating on my bill? You owe me money," and so on and so forth. I must say, at that time, I looked at my dad and I walked away, and I was crying, and I said, "You know what, this was a terrible lesson to me. This was a very, very bad lesson. It was a lesson that brought into me a lot of positivity as opposed to negativity." Mm-hmm. Negative, why the guy would tell him that in public, but positive that something has to be done.
Right.
Approximately 2 years later, from the families, at that time we were about 100 families that we were taking care of, mm-hmm. and my dad and I, we went to visit a needy family out of our neighborhood, and we noticed in one of the local restaurants from the window sitting that at the window is so wonderful sitting a couple who we are helping. Mm-hmm. And we're helping them weekly and with a nice sum of money and also with lots of food. And my dad said to me at that moment, he said to me, "You see them?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Do you have a $50 bill in your pocket?" And I said, "Dad, yes, I do." He said, "Please go in quietly without them noticing and go pay for their meal." And I did that. I got back into my car, as I was my dad's driver, and I turned to my father and I said, "Dad, can you explain?" And my father said to me, "We know their situation, and we know how bad their situation is, but if they finally found time to sit down and eat together, which means that they took the liberty, let's make it so warm and comfortable for them. This is the kind of a person he is. This is why he deserves to have what we're doing for him, what myself, my wife, my children, our family is doing in his honor." it's not just his memory, it's his honor, because of, this is the kind of person he was, and this is what, this is the memory that we have from someone who's great and someone who loved people and someone who understood that when it comes to spreading a message of goodness and kindness, you always have to live that way too. It's not just the words are easy to be said, but your actions are, you, are what you account for.
Right, and I understand he himself had a very hard, not in the conventional upbringing in the sense of that he didn't have his parents, he went to the wars and so on and so forth, and I think to come out of something and to be strong about it, and not only to, is really powerful.
It's
really
when he was when he was 5 years old, Rabbi Cohen.
Yeah.
When he was 5 years old, they killed his dad,
right.
And they threw him in the street and they told him, people like you deserve to live with the dogs.
And
he just built the other way. He was, when he was 16 years old, he saw people that were dying like flies.
This is in World War II.
Sure, he saw them dying like flies. He saw people doing the craziest things that are the most absurd things, cannibalism, right. And everything else. Right. I mean, he saw, and here he and a person. Not just he changed his life, he made this his life. This was his life was, how can I help someone else? 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning, 1 o'clock in the morning, 12 o'clock in the afternoon, 6 o'clock in the morning. This was his life at all times, just to go out and help, to do, and to spread a message, and to spread the Rebbe's message. And the Rebbe's message to the world is goodness and kindness, that our actions is what makes this world a better place, so that we just have to add just little more, and it doesn't make a difference who you are of faith, because each faith has a beautiful message, and the main thing is that we need is that the people should understand that the seven Noahide laws,
right.
When you follow
the universal code, which is
correct, which is you, thou shalt not commit idolatry, belief in God,
respect
God and praise Him, respect human life, respect the family, respect for others' rights and property, creation of a judicial system, respect all creatures.
And I'd like to just elaborate on that last point, respecting all creatures. It shows that man has the ability both to respect each other, and once you respect each other, you also have the responsibility and the opportunity to respect everything, because everything at the end of the day is created by God. And every single...
You can change the whole world.
Azach was beteva, kommen das Versehen, und davon wächst es, als es pri, es azer eliminäu. Was von dem wird echt wachsen, ist priese sehr eliminäu, in das Aginien und keiner gewollt. Sie tage ein und einziger Garin, Kerndl, aber der Kerndl ist nicht nur mit Mischaier. Und man darf haben auf der Ufanes, nur auf viele Bederich hat Teva, aber mit dem Versehen in der Neufen Hamas im Alpiteva. Und in der Mocke im Amassim Alpiteva wird von ihm Eis wachsen, an Eis Pri, oder Zera Liminehu, was von dem Zera wird echt wachsen, an Zera Liminehu, und an Zera Eis Seif, an Seif, Kolasmanim, und echt später.